In the last video, you were introduced to patching in the sequence, starting with video patching. In this lesson, we'll go through audio patching and what happens with editing mono and stereo audio in the sequence. Let's start off with the audio tabs in the sequence. Here I have a sequence that contains two stereo tracks. Stereo track 1 consists of audio channel 1 and 2. There is also another stereo track that consists of audio channels 3 and 4. At the moment, you can see that with the loaded source, the patch panel is going to edit the audio into the first stereo track and overwrite my existing edit. But a typical example you might do every day is add a background music track to accompany the camera sound. So I want to edit my stereo audio onto stereo track 2. Unlike video, the audio tabs do not follow the focus point. Secondly, you cannot drag them to the other audio tracks like you are used to from other NLEs. All you do is click on the tabs and drag to the left and right. And notice you can scroll through the audio tracks in the source clip and assign the correct one to the audio in the sequence. You will also notice that if the audio patch number was originally patched to another audio track, they will simply swap around. So when editing matching types of audio, such as mono to mono or stereo to stereo, it is all about the click and dragging of the tabs in the sequence. Now let's talk about mono and stereo audio in Smoke and how they can affect your editing. You have two types of audio tracks that can exist in the sequence. You have a mono audio track and you have a stereo audio track. Each type of audio track is capable of having source tabs to edit the audio as long as the type of source audio matches. So using the standard editing convention with insert and overwrite, you can only edit mono audio to a mono track and stereo audio to stereo tracks. At first, this does sound a bit strange why you can't appear to mix and match types of audio. However, this is because the patching in the sequence is expecting matching formats for matching tracks. This is the same reason why you can't edit audio into a video track and vice versa. However, you can still mix audio types together by dragging and dropping the sources into the sequence as opposed to editing them with the shortcuts. This forces the edit to happen and Smoke will comply and do what is needed to match the audio. In the case of the mono to stereo, Smoke will double up on the mono audio to exist in a stereo track. And in the case of a stereo source being edited into a mono audio track, Smoke will just split the stereo source into two separate mono audio tracks. A final function worth highlighting is track locking. The padlock icon on each track can be turned on, and this will prevent any changes to that particular track from any operation. In the next video, we start looking at the various editing functionality, such as insert, overwrite, and drag and drop editing.